Father God, we thank you.
天父上帝，我们感谢你。
We thank you for this time we can get together.
谢谢有这样的时间，我们可以一起聚集。
And we do a little bit review. We do a little bit looking forward.
我们做一些回顾，我们也做一些前瞻。
And Father, we pray that you reveal your own words to every one of us.
主啊，你把你自己的话语向每个人显现。
Father, we just ask for the utmost humility that we can embrace.
主啊，我们就是求我们有最大的谦卑，我们可以来接受。
And we're willing to open our hearts, our mind, receive from above.
主啊，我们愿意打开我们的心，我们可以接受从上而来的信息。
And Father, we pray for everyone.
主啊，我们为每一位祷告。
And we pray in Jesus' name.
我们祷告以耶稣的名。
Amen.
Amen.
Right. And we're going to do a quick review.
我们做一个很快的回顾。
And then we'll looking forward, okay?
然后我们再向前看。
Well, last time I talked about imperative duty.
上周我们讲到一个无可推诿的责任。
This imperative duty, I believe it's applicable to every one of us.
我认为这样一个责任是对每一位都是适用的。
All Christians, all believers, all applicable.
所有的信徒都是可以适用的。
So, the passage I use is this one.
就今天所用的经文
last time
这是上一次我用的经文。
So we are God's handiwork.
我们是神手所做的工。
In creating Christ, just do good works.
我们在耶稣里被造成是为了行善。
Which God prepared us in advance for us to do.
是神预备让我们行的。
So what God asks us to do, we must do. That's imperative.
神要我们做，我们也必须做的，这就是无可推诿的。
So the action, the deeds is what God is looking for.
这是我们的行为是神所希望看见的。
Many times we emphasize our faith, yes.
很多时候我们强调自己的信心，这是对的。
Ultimately, what God wants to see and the world wants to see is our deeds.
但是最终神要看到的和世界要看到的是我们的行为。
And then I use a very important passage here.
然后我用了一个非常重要的一个经文在这里。
And this, we talk about Bible, we talk about scriptures.
在这里我们说到是圣经。
We do everything in a week so that we'll learn and we familiar with what the Bible says and teaches.
所以我们做我们一切的来研读圣经。
All right, I want to remind you the dots at the end.
我上次跟大家讲到那个最后的那几个点。
For those who came last week, I want you to remind it or memorize what was the dot line.
我希望大家能记住上一次我那个隐藏省略的那一部分。
Okay, let's read all together, shall we?
让我们一起念。
All right, including the dots at the end.
包括那个省略的部分。
Okay, one, two, three.All scripture is God-breathed and is useful for teaching, rebuking, correcting, and training in righteousness, so that the servant of God may be thoroughly equipped for what?
行各样的。
This is important.
这是很重要的。
If we don't know what's the dots,
如果我们不知道省略的部分的话
，And there's no point to study the Bible.
那学习圣经就变得没有意义了。
All right, now let's read one more time and place your emphasis at the very end.
让我们再念一遍。
All right, shall we? One, two, three. All
圣经都是神所默示的，于教训、督责、使人归正、教导人学义，都是有益的，叫属神的人得以完全，预备行各样的。善事。
All right. Okay, one more time. Sorry, this is kind of slow. Okay, 我来动哈，你们不要动。Okay. Don't do for me. All right. Okay, 好，那我再来一次。All right, one more time. All right.
好，再念一遍。
All
圣经都是神所默示的，
有
教训、督责、使人归正、教导人学义，都是有益的，叫属神的人得以完全，预备行各样的善事。
So we scripture. What's the purpose of learning of scripture?
那学习圣经的意义何在
？Is to do good works.
是行各样的善事。
If we don't do good works,
如果我们不行善事
Minds will forget about scriptures.
我们就可以忘记圣经了。
The purpose of reading, studying, doing all go seminaries is to do good works.
学习圣经的唯一的目的就是做行善事。
If you don't have good works, useless in church.
如果你没有行出来的善事，在教会是无用的。
I tell you, it's useless to God.
也对神而言是无用的。
I'm not just kidding you. Scripture.Told us so. We have to do good works.
我没有在开玩笑，这是圣经说我们必须做
善事。What is good works?
那什么是善事？
I'll tell you what's good works.
我告诉你们什么是善事。
Kind of slow. Ah, I hate this. Come on. All right. I remember I gave you three blocks for those people who came last Sunday,
上周我 放了三段。
When we have three blocks, we can roughly know where we are.
在这三段当中，我们大约可以知道什么是爱。
What on the to the left is all humanly, freshly.
那左边那一段是讲到人肉体的。
Towards the right hand side is more godly, more holy.
右边的是比较属神的。
I believe all the works is on the right hand side.
我们的行为行善应该是在右边。
So we have lust, we have like, and we have agape.
所以我们有贪欲，我们有喜欢，有大爱。
All right, and we have. Okay, now you come all together. All right.So, forgive this is technical difficulty, but you can see it's all there because it's a godly and from the world. It's making the difference.
所以说把他们都放在一起的时候，大家可以看到属世界的和属神的是不一样的。
You can see out of our nature, out of carnal body, we tend to go to the left.
出于我们的肉体，出于我们的本性，我们通常会偏到左边。
But when you move to the right, you see it's a purposeful, it's a mindful act.
但是当我们趋向右边的时候，我们发现那是一个我们刻意的、主动的行为。
And then we are more of independent versus dependent, and so forth.
然后是一个更加独立的。
This gives us some kind of idea.What kind of good works we need to perform?
这给我们一个大致的含义，告诉我们爱是什么样。
So in a marriage, in the world, we pretty much can tell where is the area, where is the good works God is more desired of.
所以在世界上，在我们的婚姻里，我们可以大约看到神期望的善行是怎么样。
So if we want to do good works, go to the right.
如果我们想行善事的话，我们要到右边。要到右边的区域。
Don't stay with what you like.
不要只停留在我们喜欢的事情上。
Because in this world, everybody do what he enjoys or she likes. That's it.
因为这个世界上每一个人都做自己喜欢的事情。
Long as I like, I'm not hurting other people. Why not?
只要我喜欢，我愿意，我不伤害到别人，为什么不可以做？
So everybody enjoy himself or herself.
每个人都喜悦自己的行为。
This is not a good work.
这些并不是善行。
This is not will be not counted in the eyes of the Lord.
这些在神的眼中并不算作善行。
We want to do good. We want to do God's kind of work.
我们要做那个好的那个属神的行为。
All on the right hand side.
那都是在右边这个区域内。
A love out of your will, out of your determination.All of your volition, you pay attention to others, not to yourself, and be independent.
所以这个爱是出于我们自愿，出于我们自己的决心，是我们决定要如此去做。
So the conclusion is this from last week.
那上周的结论是
，This is very important. All right, never mind. Okay, let's read the first one. We are not saved by good works.
我们不是靠着善行得救。
But the purpose of being saved is to do good works.
但是我们得救的目的是行善。
This is very important.
这个非常重要。
Many of us thinking of, I can be saved through the doing or the deeds of my good works.
很多人认为我们 是通过做这些善事才能够得救。
This is not our faith.
这个并不是一个信心。
We saved through grace.
我们是靠着恩典才能得救。
Through faith.
是借着我们的信心。
So that we can do good works.
然后得救以后，我们才可以去行善。
Please do not reverse.
请不要把这个次序颠倒。
So we are saved to do works, but not saved by good works.
我们得救是为了去行善，但不是因为行善才得救。
And the ultimate purpose of our faith is to do good works and to serve God.
所以我们信仰的最终的目的是服侍神去行善。
Therefore, I might believe this.All believers show your deeds and works to prove your faith.
所以我个人的观点是，所有的信徒应该通过我们的行为证明我们的信心。
I tell you, one day God will ask us to produce our good works to prove to the world, am I a believer or not?
我相信有一天神会让我们展现出我们的行为，证明给世界看我们的信心在哪里。
If you and I cannot produce, present.Evidence, God will say your faith is nothing but a fake.
如果有一天我们不能展现我们信心的证据，神会说你的信心是假的。
So therefore, I believe I need to illustrate and emphasize one more time. That's imperative duty. We need to produce good works.
我想再次强调一遍，这是我们不可推诿的责任，就是去行善。
All right, now we're going to continue.
下面让我们继续。
All right.I'm going to highlight the word saved.
我要特别讲到这个字，就是得救。
Yes, we are not saved by good works, but saved to do good works.
我们不因为善行得救，但却因为得救而行善。
I'm ask you, what do you mean by saved?
那得救的意义是什么？
What do you mean by saved?
得救的意义是什么？
What is to you?
对于你而言，它的意义是什么？
Many of us, when we talk about being saved,
当我们说到得救的时候
we are saved from hell. Is that right?
我们是从地狱被救上来。
Yes, if there is a hell, I want to be saved from hell.
如果真的有地狱的话，我希望能从地狱里被救出来。
But we are wrong.
但是我们错了。
Yes, we will be saved from hell.
是的，一方面我们确实会从地狱被救出来。
I tell you, we are saved from sins.
但是我告诉你们，我们是被从我们的罪里救出来。
We should have a mindset. We should be saved from sins, not just from hell.
我要告诉大家，我们要有这样的正确的思想，就是我们是从罪里面被救出来。
Yes, saving from hell, it's a bonus, but you cannot stop there.
所以从被地狱里面救出来是一个副产品。
Therefore, I want to emphasize, we should be saved from sins, but not from hell.
所以我要强调的是，我们是从罪里面被救出来，而是
and we saved to what?
然后被救出来，我们被救到哪里去呢？
Many of us say we are saved to happiness.
很多人说到我们得救是要被救到快乐里去。
But I tell you, the true, the genuine, the godly idea of being saved is to holiness.
但是我要说，真正的从神而来的，我们得救的去处是圣洁。
We are not saved from hell, not just from hell.
我们得救并不只是从地狱里面被救出来。
From sin.
我们真正的是从罪里面被救出来。
We are saved to holiness, but not happiness.
我们得救是要进到圣洁里，而不只是进到快乐里。
There is nothing wrong to be saved from hell.
从地狱里面得救本身并没有错。
There is nothing wrong you saved to happiness.
得救以后我们得到快乐本身也没有错。
But I tell you, this is only a beginning, a starting point.
但是这些只是一个开始，起点。
Many of us.Stay at the starting point until the very end, making it also the end point.
我们很多的时候只是停留在起点，把起点当作终点。
I want to be saved from hell. Okay, I believed once, I'm done, because I want to start here and end here.
如果我们从地狱得救，但是我们 又说我们一次得救而永远得救的话，我们就永远停留在起点。
I could tell you most of Christian so called are like this.
我可以说大部分被称作基督徒的都是这样。
I want to bring up a very serious caution today.
我今天想带出一个非常严肃的警告。
I'm going to ask you this question.
我要问一个问题。
Am I saved or not?
我到底得救了没有？
You may think you are.
也许你认为你已经得救。
But we need to be challenged.
但是我们要挑战自己这样一个问题。
I need to seriously ask every one of us, including myself.
我要很严肃地去问每一个人，包括我自己。
Am I saved or not?
我到底得救了没有？
All right, first passage, I'm going to show it to you.
那第一段我要给大家看的经文。
Well, I did not rehearse with Li Yan.
我并没有和李艾一起来准备。
I could see she likes Gospel of John.
我可以说他可能很喜欢约翰福音。
Well, just accidentally, I also use, you know, a passage from.
我也是正好也用到了约翰福音的经文。
Right. This verse we all know.
我们都知道这一节经文。
But there is a hidden meaning, and I did not find out until just recently.
那直到最近我才发现这节经文有一些隐藏的内容。
You know what? I'm ashamed of myself.
我自己都觉得惭愧。
I believe Christ like a 50, okay, not 15, all right, 50 years almost.
我信主已经50年。
And I have to apologize to all of you because I've been here 14 years almost.
我在这里也已经有14年。
I'm also learning these truths just recently.
我还是在不断地学习真理。
This passage sounds so simple, but yes, so difficult.
那这一节经文看上去如此简单，但是它其实非常困难。
You know what's the key words in this passage?
那关键字在这一节经文里面是哪一个？
You know what's the key word of this passage?
这节经文的关键字是什么？
What do you think is a key word?
关键字。
Usually, most of the time, it's a verb. Which one?
通常我们认为是一个动词。
What is the key words, the most important words here?
最重要的那个词在这里是哪一个？
Which one? All right, believes, right?
就是相信，信他的信。
Okay, now the key come into play here.
那最重要的那个字是
This word believes.
这个信，信心的信这个字。
Or Chinese 信 doesn't.Tell us the whole story.
这个字并没有把故事讲完全。
As a matter of fact, it misleading us in many ways.
在某些程度上，它有一点误导我们。
When the author write these words,
当这个作者写下这个字的时候
，in Greek,
它是在希腊文里面。
You know what kind of word he used?
那在希腊文里面，这个字是哪个字呢
？He used in a I'll translate.Into English tense.
这个字被在英文的那个时态里面，它是一个动词。
It's a participle, present, active, nominative, masculine, singular.
什么现
？Okay.
现
If you study Bible, if you study the Greek, you have to parse the words.
如果你学习圣经，学习这希腊文的话。你要，
I'm not going to give you all the names.
我不会把这些所有的名词都跟你们讲。
But the key point is participle present active. 动名词。现在动名词，现在进行式。That means whoever is continue believing.
他的意思是，如果谁是在持续当中一直的。在相信
is not just believe once or twice.
不是说只是相信过一次或两次。
This bring out a lot of insight.
这给了我们很多的看见。
We often missed it.
我们经常忽视了这一点。
We think we believed once. That's all it takes.
我们以为我们相信过一次就可以了。
Dear brothers and sisters, it's wrong.
兄弟姐妹们，这个观点是错误的。
I'll give you another proof.
我给你们另外一个证明。
End of the Gospel of John.
在这个约翰福音结尾的时候
And chapter 20, last verse.
20章最后一节.
It's the conclusion, it's a summary of John.
是一个约翰福音的总结.
You know, when you read a book, you need to read the summary. You need to read the conclusion, don't you?
读一本书的时候, 你需要去读那个结论.
The conclusion, the most important of the whole book of John is this verse.
整本约翰福音最重要的一节是在这里.
Same thing, believe.
还是讲到相信.
And also, this one has a little bit better, it's a believing.
所以这个字 翻译的稍好一些。
Yeah, it's a verb, it's also participle, present, active, nominative, masculine, plural. It's many people are doing it. Last one is a single person doing it.
这是同样是讲是一个现在进行时，是很多人。
Now come to my point.
那我的观点是，
What do you mean by believe?
那相信的意思是什么？
What do you mean by believe in Christ?
相信基督是什么意思？
Oh, man, I hate this. Okay, the first one is we'll talk about tense.
第一个我讲到关于时态。
It's active present participle.
是一个主动的，是一个现在的进行时。
This we cannot miss it because it means continuing believing, keep on believing.
是一个持续的相信，一个一直的相信。
It's not believe once or twice.
不是只是相信一次或两次。
It's a continual present tense, continuing going on.
是一个持续的现在的进行的。
It's non-stop.
是没有停顿的。
Until very end.
一直到最后的。
And this brings us to a light. Am I a real believer?
这个给我们这样一个问题，我们真的在相信吗？
You may believe in sincerely, honestly in 20 years, 2 years, or yesterday. It doesn't mean you believe in today.
即便你很真正的相信了二十年，一直到昨天，不代表今天你还在真正的相信。
If you look at all these, the verb using in John, always talk about continuing believing.
如果你研究约翰福音中的这些动词，你发现它是讲到一个在持续一个进行的过程。
It's not momentarily. It's not just for a while.
不是偶然的，不是一个。 一段时间的,
it's lasting faith until very end.
是一个持续的相信，一直到最后的时候。
Oh boy, I'm ashamed of myself. I did not discover this until recently.
直到如今，我自己也才发现这个问题。
I could not wait to tell you every one of you.
我不能等，我要告诉每一位。
The church of the problem is this one.
那我们教会的问题在这一点上。
Majority of us, for a time in the past, a time for a moment, we believe sincerely, honestly, yes.
在过去的某一个时间点上，我们是真正的相信了。
But why we are so weak?
那为什么我们今天还是很软弱？
Because we did not continue.
因为我们没有持续的相信。
Because I believe I did my job 20 years ago.
因为我们以为我们20年前就已经完成这项工作。
It's all done.
这项工作完成了。
It's wrong.
但是这是错误的。
Our faith is not believe once and that's it. Once saved, forever saved. It's wrong. It's a condition attached to it.
我们不是相信了一次就完了，这是一个持续的过程。
Therefore, I believe this. Our faith is justification, sanctification, and glorification. Yes.
我相信我们的信仰是称义，是成圣，是得荣耀。
Justification is a beginning.
称义是一个开始。
God justified us in the very beginning.
神在开始的时候称我们为义。
He counted us as righteousness.
他算我们为义。
He put a sheepskin on me like a wolf. He counted me as a sheep.
他把羊皮披在我们这些狼的身上，把我们算作羊。
Then I have to go through a way of sanctification.
然后我们要经历这个成圣的过程。
A lifelong sanctification.
这个成圣是一生的过程。
But yet in God's view, it's only temporal as an internship I share with you many times.
但是从神看来，这只是一个短暂的一个实习的过程。
And then glorification, we enter the eternity. That's forever and ever.
然后最后我们可以进到这个荣耀里，那个是永恒的。
But many of us stop at justification. I believe That's it. My job done.
但是我们很多时候只停留在称义上。
We have to be careful. Are we really a believer or not?
我们要很小心，我们是不是一个真正的信徒。
I believe we could lose our faith.
我相信我们可能会失去我们的救恩。
Yes, God can keep us, but that's His part of the job. We have to carry out our own share of responsibility.
神会保守我们，那是神的责任，但是我们自己也有我们自己的责任。
Sanctification is majority we have to participate actively engaged.
那成圣我们要很主动的参与到这个过程当中。
Okay, and then and in just, justification is by faith. By God's grace.
称义是靠着神的恩典。
Through faith, by grace, we are justified.
我们靠着神的，靠着以着借着我们的信心，靠着神的恩典。
In this process, we have to demonstrate, we have to produce our deeds.
然后在这个过程当中，我们借着我们的行为来证明我们的信心。
I like the verses in Hebrew I shared with you several weeks ago. In fact, that we have produced, in fact, our deeds.
我们在那个希伯来书前几周跟大家分享，我们要在事实上，我们要证明。
We have to prove to the God and prove to the world that we are a genuine believer.
我们证明给神看，证明给世界看，我们是一个真正的信徒。
And then it's a continuous, lifelong process. It's a package.
这是一个持续的，是一个一生之久的一个过程。
Our faith is a whole package. It's not one point of history of my life. I believe, and that's it.
我们的信心不是我们生命中的某一个时间点，而是包含了我们很多的过程。
I want to warn you, every one of us.
我想警告我们每一位。
Are we like that?
我们是不是这样做的？
Are we still continue believing? And producing good deeds.
我们有没有持续的来相信，并且有好的行为？
This is a serious business.
这个是非常严肃的话题。
I'm going to use one passage to prove to you.
我还要用一节经文来证明。
All right, it's on the bulletin.
这个在我们的周报上。
And I'm going to ask Minji to read in Chinese. Okay, if you don't have it, just look it up there.
如果你没有这些经文，可以看屏幕。
I want to bring up the good points of this whole passage. All right, since the majority of understand Chinese, we're going to read in Chinese.
好，我们下面用中文来念《路加福音》14:25-35。有极多的人和耶稣同行，他转过来对他们说。人到我这里来，若不爱我。
Okay, well, let's read out all together then. All right.
然后让我们一起念。
All right. Okay. Start from beginning. One more time.
重新开始。
Everybody read out loud. You can hear yourself. Okay. 1, 2, 3.
有极多的人和耶稣同行，他转过来对他们说：“人到我这里来，若不爱我，胜过爱自己的父母、妻子、儿女、弟兄、姐妹和自己的性命，就不能做我的门徒。凡不背着自己十字架跟从我的，也不能做我的门徒。”你们哪一个要盖一座楼，不先坐下算计花费，能盖成不能呢？恐怕安了地基不能成功。看见的人都笑话他，说：“这人开了工却不能完工。”或是一个王出去和别的王打仗，若不先坐下来酌量，能用10,000兵去敌那领20,000兵来攻打他的吗？若是不能，就趁敌人还远的时候，便派使者去求河西的条款。这样你们无论什么人，若不撇下一切所有的，就不能做我的门徒。盐本是好的，盐若失了味，可用什么叫它再咸呢？或用在田里，或堆在粪里，都不合适，只好丢在外面。有耳可听的就应当听。
Once upon a time, there was a big crowd following Jesus.
那个时候曾经有一大群的人跟随耶稣。
He says was accompanying Jesus.
他们去被叫做耶稣的同伴。
I don't know what's the occasion.
我不知道那个是个什么情况。
Maybe after a miracle.
也许是耶稣刚行了神迹之后。
Maybe he performed some kind of 5 breads and 2 fish.
也许他刚行过那个五鱼 五饼二鱼的事情。
A lot of people got excited.
很多人都很兴奋的来跟随他。
Wow, if somebody like this, who else I should follow?
如果有一个这样的人，我还需要为什么还要需要跟从别人呢？
Isn't that great if we have a lot of followers?
是不是很好？如果有他有很多的跟从者。
If you have a lot of followers on Twitter, are you going to be happy?
如果你在Twitter 上有很多的那个跟从者，你是不是很高兴呢？
A lot of people say great on your Facebook. Will you be thrilled?
如果有很多人在你的那个脸书，你是不是也很高兴？
We all like followers, don't we?
我们都喜欢有人跟从我们。
Right? Young people, do you like followers?
是不是呢？
Your parents like, you know, I like everybody follow me.
我们希望所有人都来跟随我。
Well, Jesus wasn't that thrilled.Too happy.
耶稣是不是非常兴奋呢？
He turned around and tell them this story.
然后他转过来跟这群人讲了这个故事。
Well, what's the point of this story?
那这个故事的重点在哪里？
If you want to follow me, you have to calculate.
如果你们想要跟随我，你们要计算。
And ready to pay the price.
然后预备付上代价。
Wow.I thought I'd come to follow Jesus to get free bread.
我以为我跟随耶稣可以得到免费的面包。
I come every Friday. I have free dinner, not just free lunch.
也许我以为星期五晚上来可以得到免费的晚餐。
I follow Jesus to go to church. I want to take advantage of it.
我跟随基督来到教会，我是以为有利可图。
I know a lot of people. They can do business with me.
然后很多人会给我很多礼物。
I will sell product to them.
我可以卖给他们很多的产品。
I have a good connections, networking. Is that all about?
我可以建立很多的人际关系。
Follow Jesus is just the bonus on the side.
这我从跟随基督得到很多的好处。
My interest comes first, so I follow Jesus.
因为我的很多利益可以得到满足，所以我跟随基督。
This is not.What the passage, the scripture, the parable tell us.
但是这个不是这一节经文所告诉我们的。
He warns the followers, you're ready to pay the price or not.
耶稣警告他的跟随者，你们有没有准备好来付上代价。
In the same way, therefore, not one of you can be my disciple if he does not renounce all his own possessions.
耶稣说，如果你们不能够放下自己一切所有的，你们就不能做我的门徒。
I tell the truth, I cannot do that.
说实话，我自己也做不到。
I don't believe anybody in the world can truly 100% of the time can do that.
我也相信这世上没有一个人可以百分之百的做到。
But I'm going to ask you, are you willing to do it?
但是我问你们，你们愿不愿意去做？
Or are you ready to do it?
并且你们有没有准备好去做？
If you or I are not ready, we are not worthy to be called his disciple.
如果我们没有准备好，我们就不配称作他的门徒。
And this is a serious matter. I want to challenge everyone.
我想挑战每一位。
I don't believe God's words is worth of kidding. Oh, just joke around. It's all nothing serious.
我不认为神在这边是在开玩笑。
If you and I are not ready to pay all costs, we are not worthy of the disciple.
如果我们不愿付上所有的代价，我们就不配做他的门徒。
I want to highlight the last part.
我想，重点放在最后这个部分。
The highlight of the salt part.
就是关于盐的那一部分。
Alright, never mind then. Okay. The last part is interesting.
这最后一部分很有趣。
It says salt is good.
他说盐本来是好的。
Okay, remember this. This parable talk about the cost of being a disciple.
请大家记住这个预言是讲的做门徒的代价。
Following immediately is the salt parable. Salt parable of salt.
那关于盐的这个比喻是讲到我们要立刻的跟随
直接在后面。
Follow immediately. 是直接的接着上一个预言。
Okay, this parable is very puzzling as well.
那这个比喻也很难解。
While we can set them aside, we can put them together.
我们可以把它分成两个比喻，也可以把它们合成一个比喻。
I believe it's the same.
我相信这个是这两说的是同一件事。
The salt means some disciples did not calculate the cost and yet still follow.
我相信这个盐是某些新门徒没有计算过这个代价，却决定跟随基督。
And he just like building a building, but built halfway, he cannot finish it, and everybody will laugh at him, just like the parable says.
就好像前一个比喻讲的一个。盖一座楼盖到一半却没有完成被人嘲笑。
Or a king does not have the strength to fight his enemy, but he's not asking for peace. He still wants to fight.
也好像这一个王因为打不过他的敌人却没有和敌人和解仍然想去打仗。
And he got lost at the end.
他在最后会失败。
And these two type of people, I believe, is what the saw represents.
我相信盐就代表了这样两种人。
Salt is good, but if lose its flavor, what good is it anymore?
盐虽然是好的，但是盐若失了味，它还有什么用呢？
Useless to God.
对神而言是无用的。
Am I useful to God?
我对神有没有用呢？
Are you useful to God?
你对神有没有用？
Once you and I become a believer,
当我们一旦我们成为了信徒，
God has purpose in your life.
神在你们的生命中是有目的的。
He has a great plan for you.
神有很伟大的计划。
You are built with a purpose in mind.
你们是神预先造出来的。
Do good works.
预备行各样的善事。
But if you do not do the good works,
如果你不行善事，
waste God's mind.
那是浪费了神的恩典。
Useless to Him.
对神来讲就是无用的。
What is the result? What's the ending of the flavor salt?
那最后这个 无味的盐的后果是什么？
Neither good for the soil nor the manure pile.
或在田里或堆在粪里。
Throw it out.
只好丢在外面。
I believe many of believers, so-called believers, will be thrown out one day because you and I did not produce what we need to produce.
我相信有一天很多信徒都会被丢在外面，因为我们没有做到我们应该做的。
I want to warn every one of us.
我希望警告我们每一位。
Don't take lightly.
不要轻看这件事。
You and I could lose our salvation.
我们也许会失去我们的救恩。
Our faith is like life. A baby was born to this earth.
我们的信心好像一个刚出生的婴儿。
You need to be fed, you need to be grow, you need to be put nutrient in there so he can produce good works.
他要被人喂养，他要有营养才能长大。
If you have ignored your faith all these years,
如果我们这么多年来一直忽视我们的信仰，
your faith is probably a fake, or a dead one, or dying one.
我们的信仰也许是一个假的，也许已经死了或快要死了。
You can fool me, you can fool your brothers and sisters.
你可以欺骗牧师可以欺骗兄弟姐妹，
But you cannot fool God.
但是没有办法欺骗神。
I want to bring this most severe warning to every one of us.
我想带出这个最为严重的警告。
We need to examine ourselves. Am I a true believer or not?
我们要重新审视自己，我们是不是一个真正的信徒。
In Hebrew chapter 6,
希伯来书第六章。
We haven't gone there yet.
我们还没有讲，我还没讲到这一章。
If you and I receive the blessing of God, and yet we forsake in the middle of the way, nothing can save us anymore.
如果我们接受神的恩典却半途放弃了，
nothing.
就没有什么可以再救我们的了。
Nothing can save us anymore.
没有任何可以来救我们的。
So I plead to you.
所以我请求大家。
If your faith is dying.
如果你的信心正在死亡，
Get up and revive and repent.
起来，来悔改。
While there is still chance.
在还有机会的时候。
Am I saved or not?
我到底得救了没有？
I want to ask everyone.
我想问每一个人这样的问题。
First of all, I bring out God's part.
第一个我讲到关于神的部分。
God's promise is promise.
神的应许就是应许。
He will keep it.
他会守他的应许。
That's his part of responsibility.
这是他的责任。
He will do his part.
他会做好他的部分。
But,
但是呢
faith demands us, requires of us, we do our share.
但是我们的信心要求我们要做好我们自己的责任
till the very very end
一直到最后的时候
we need to ready to pay the price
我们要准备好去付上这个代价
I don't believe anybody can be excused
我不认为任何人有借口
demand us we need to produce our good works
要求我们去要有好的行为
all the way to the end
要一直到最后的时候
Has my deeds proved my faith?
让我的行为来证明我的信心
Has my lifestyle attested to my belief?
让我的生活的方式证明我的信心
Well, the grammar is wrong. I correct, but somehow I got an old file. We need to prove to ourselves.
我们要证明给自己
We need to prove to the world.
我们要证明给世界
I like the word lifestyle.
我喜欢这个生活方式这个词。
How long ago you have believed Christ?
你信主有多久了
?One year?
是一年吗
?Five years?
还是五年
?Or 10 years?
或者十年
?Have you changed the lifestyle after 10 years you've been Christ?
在信主十年以后你的生活的方式有没有改变
?If your mindset is the same as before,
如果你的思想是和以前一样的
If your thinking style is same as before you believe in Christ
如果你的思想模式和以前和没信主之前也是一样的
I would like to challenge you, think again
我想挑战你再考虑一下这个问题
You may think you've been saved from hell
你也许想以为你从地狱里面得救了
I don't know, I cannot tell you the answer
我不知道我不能告诉你答案
Maybe, maybe not
也许不是
Because you and I cannot produce deeds.
因为我们没有行为
Lifestyle is a serious matter.
生活方式是很重要的
I challenge every one of you.
我挑战每一位
Live a lifestyle of holiness, not happiness.
我们过一个圣洁的以一个圣洁的生活方式而不是一个快乐的生活方式。
Everyone is pursuing happiness, isn't that right?
每一个人都在追随快乐。
In America, it's a land of pursue happiness.
美国是一个追寻快乐的国度。
If you and I pursue nothing but happiness, not holiness, we need to take caution.
如果我们只是在追随快乐而没有圣洁的话。
If you are trying to save yourself from hell, not from sins,We need to be cautious.
如果我们只是想从地狱里面得救，而不是想从罪恶里面得救的话，我们也要小心了。
Re-examine our faith.
我们要好好的重新检查一下我们的信仰。
Repent.
悔改。
Why we still have chance? Why we still have time?
当我们还有机会、时间的时候
，I plead to you, repent.
我请求大家悔改。
We don't have tomorrow. Maybe, maybe not.
We don't know.不一定有明天。
Everyone need to be cautious. We need to be humble ourselves. God have mercy on us. Help us willing to pay the price.
我们每一个人都要警醒，我们要愿意去付上代价。
Many of us thinking once for saved, forever saved. No.
一次得救，永远得救是错误的。
I don't like to bring good news. I like to be a good guy.
我想成为一个。好人
But I have to tell you the truth.
但是我还是要告诉大家这个真理
Not until recently I feel the urgency
直到最近我感受到了这个迫切感
Church need to grow
教会需要成长
Not in numbers
不是在数量上
I don't believe God need weak soldiers No
我不认为神需要软弱的士兵
God needs strong, willing soldiers. Only a few. That's all it takes.
神只需要也许数量不多但是强壮的士兵。
But we have too many weak believers.
但是我们有了太多的软弱的士兵。
Are you willing to pay the price?
你愿不愿意付上代价？
I want to challenge all leaders.
我想挑战每一位做带领的。
If you serve in church in any capacity,
如果你以任何的自己的能力在服侍教会，
If you're not willing to pay the price,
如果你不愿意付上代价，
Everybody look up to you.
每一个人都会看着你。
Why bother? He's not paying the price.
他也没有付上代价。
Why bother? I enjoy my happiness.
为什么我们要这样做？我们为什么不去享受快乐？
We forgot God's principle.
因为我们忘记了神的准则。
Long as there's food and clothes, we should be content.
有衣有食，我们就当知足。
How greedy we have become all these years.
我们这些长时间以来，我们变得多么的贪婪。
Greedy is a sin.
贪婪也是一个罪。
We need to pray for the forgiveness of our sins.
我们要为我们的罪，我们来悔改。
I cannot emphasize more.
我不能再更加强调了。
Repent, every one of us.
每一位要悔改。
Let's pay the price.
让我们付上代价。
Let's get serious.
让我们重视起来。
While there's still time, help us to be a loyal, faithful servant of His.
让我们还有时间的时候，做他忠诚的一个仆人。
Let's all pray.
让我们一起祷告。
Father God, forgive us.
天父上帝，赦免我们。
We are a bunch of pathetic, pitiful sinners.
主啊，我们只是一群可怜的罪人。
We cannot save ourselves.
我们甚至不能救自己。
We'd like to save us from the fire, the hell.
帮助我们从地狱的火里面帮我们救出来。
But seldom we ask you to save us from sins.
但是同时，我们也求你帮我们从罪中拯救出来。
We ask for happiness, but we're not asking for holiness.
我们曾经只是要求快乐，我们并没有要求向你求圣洁。
We think we can enjoy the happiness on this world and holiness in the other world.
我们以为我们在这个世界上享受快乐，在死了以后可以享受圣洁。
This is reversed.
主啊，我们颠倒了次序。
You intend us live a holy life, and then in eternity we can enjoy a happy life.
你的本意是让我们在世上过圣洁的生活，在永恒里可以有快乐。
Father, forgive us our ignorance and our stupidity, and Father, help us to be reminded again.
天父啊，赦免我们的无知，给仍然怜悯我们。
And we think we can get the best of both worlds.
我们以为我们在两个世界里面都可以享受到最好的。
Yet we lost all the good intent you have prepared for us.
但是我们却失去了你在我们心中所预备的。
Very costly to be your disciple, Christ.
我们成为你的门徒是要付上很多代价的。
And Father, many times we reluctant.
但是很多时候我们变得懒惰。
Forgive us.
请你赦免我们。
Help us to repent.
帮助我们来悔改。
Turn back.
让我们 转身
and put into action.
可以有行为。
And Father, help us to do it.
帮助我们如此行。
Not just saying it.
不只是说说而已。
Not just proclaiming it.
不只是宣告一下。
Father, help us put in action.
但是帮助我们行在我们的行为上。
And pray for everyone, including myself.
我为每一位包括自己祷告。
Jesus' name.
以耶稣的名。Amen.